Hey kids, welcome back to part 3 of the Vampire Castle build. Now this was originally going to be a 4-part series, but it's probably going to be more than that. So this is where we left off. It's the entry gate at this tower with Mrs. Vampire on there. Push that to the side. And we're now on to the original bag number 4. But of course, we don't have the bags, but we have all the pieces. And the kids were playing with the pieces in between the filmings here, so bear with me if I have to disassemble some stuff that they put together. All right, so here's where we start building the spiky trap pit area. This is a pretty cool little feature. You have this round brick with these studs with holes in the top. And each one of these little rubbery spike pieces, which always slip out of my fingers, goes into one of these holes. So we have a total of 12 spikes on there. So if you fall in this, it's pretty much going to be an insta-death. Of all pieces, these little rubbery spikes are my least favorite. Not that they look bad, I think they look great when they're put on and when they're used in the right scenarios like this, but I dislike how hard it is to put each one on. Missing one. I know it's around here somewhere. All right, I'll come back to that because I know I have them around. Let's move on. Not waste any time. Some of these pieces semi-sorted. Brick. These profile bricks. 2x2 brick. Then we have 3 panels. One of them is stickered and the other 2 are not. So the non-stickered ones will go there. Let me find the stickered one that I'm looking for. This is one of the few sets that I did put all the stickers on because I knew I'd be rebuilding it to use for holiday decoration. So I get a lot of, I'll say one of the number one comments I get on most all my videos is either why don't you put stickers on, or the other comment I'll get is, put stickers on. So it's either a question or a statement, but it's the same thing. They either say, why not, or just do it. All right. And if you've seen any of my videos, you know why not. And you know why I won't just do it. No point in me re-explaining it to everyone that already knows. If you don't know, maybe that's a good hint to go watch my other videos. I know, it's a shameless plug. Well, it's actually not. I'm not shamed. It's just a plug. Alright, so our tower shape's coming together. I've left one of the little spots open for the other spike whenever I find it. Problem is I have all the pieces more or less just spread around everywhere. They're sorted by similar color, but there's not many whites and browns and maroon colors, so I have all of those same colors all piled up over here, so that one little spike is probably hiding in that pile somewhere. Okay. And who knows, it may not be. I may have to just go get a spare. This tower piece is using a lot of the brick bricks in light bluish gray. Three more panels. Of course, one is stickered and the other two are blank. There we go. So we've got a good little tower going on now. Windows, so these are the brown windows with the black, I guess, bars inside each one. I've got two arches to hold them on. There, right there. Slope over here. Now we're gonna get some trapdoor action going on with this piece, black cone. Here's our little trap door. So we've got this trap door up here, and you have this black cone over here on the side, and when you pull it out, The door falls. Whoever's up here, unluckily, falls all the way down into the pit of spikes. So that is a very tragic way to meet your maker. But that's the way the vampires roll. If you're gonna play in the vampire house, you're gonna have to deal with some trickery. So this is, here's the bait to get you up in the secret room. It's a secret map. So someone comes up, it's gonna view the secret map. Let's say it's this guy. And he's gonna say, aha, I have all your secrets. And then, sorry, dead. All right, so that's the base of this tower. So now what we're gonna build is a capping piece to go on that. So we're gonna start with this little base plate that has this hole in the middle. Or I guess it's a cutout, it's not a hole. You see, it's the same shape as the bases that we've been using for all the towers in this set. So we're gonna build it on top of that. No big deal. Quite a few little pieces in this build, this little step. So I'm going to pull them all together for ease of finding them. All right. Six. Can't quite remember what these are for. This is just for decor. So now we have two of the brown arched windows with the little molded door piece in there. And the door is, looks like it's hinged to open side to side, but it actually opens with a hinge up and down. It's a little bit different. This. It's pretty clever how they did it. We have another window here with the little black, kind of like jail cell bars. And one more on a 2x2 sloped brick. Back to one with a wooden window piece on a 2x2 sloped brick. Goes there. So you can see we have all these windows all the way around it. Arches, and here's the clever part, is these arches actually slip down over these bars. See that on the inside here, there's these two bars and then a stud over that window. Well, the bars will go right inside of that brick, and then the middle stud will clip onto the stud on the window. Pretty clever little trick there. A few arches, a couple reverse slopes, and one just hit the floor. So here's the tricky part also, it's putting, how do you get all this to hold together at the top? It's held together with these 1x4 brown plates. And you have a couple brown tiles to cover up the stud. Of that corner brick piece. And then just a 1x1 plate on the end right there. So that gives us all the studs that we can now attach our tan top plate to. Tricky lining all these studs up, but once you get it on there, it really does hold this together pretty well. So you can see all the different amount of ins and outs and detailing on that little tower cap piece. So now we have another one of these pieces sticking out of the side of the castle. What's it held on with though? This. Treasure chest, which has a clear green and a yellow gem in it, right there in the top, and then it has one of these big molded tower pieces right there. And then on top of that we have whole little finale detail. put these little cones on there, all the way stacking them, creating a nice little point with this bar, and then that little ball joint. All that, and it goes right there. Oops, I put the wrong cone on. Right there. There we go. Now we have one more. Very similar, but a little bit shorter. So we got a round brick, cone, cone, bar, ball joint. Right there. And we have still one more to do. This medium cone, small cone, a bar, a ball joint, and a 1x2 round plate. This one goes all the way on the top. There are three separate kind of cone finale pieces. And then all of this, and I had to zoom out pretty far, goes right on top. There. So this is why you can see there's the hole that we looked at in this plate here. So it's going to go right on top of all of the stuff that was already built. And it allows plenty of room in there. You can see the, the map room, whatever you want to call it, right there. It gives us plenty of room to get a minifigure in there and have that trapdoor function work. And then up here, where the hidden treasure is. Now all of this, you notice if you're paying attention closely, this has the Technic pinholes right there and right there. So this allows it to pull our other piece down here. This allows it to connect these pins on the end of these, line right up with those pin holes, and voila. You can see now the castle is really coming together. So that's where we're at. You can kind of see now all the pieces that are kind of spread around everywhere. I'm still missing one white spike, which I'm sure I'll find as we build more. And once I do, I'll drop it in there. But that's it for now. This is the end of part 3. What we've done is we've finished instruction book number 1. So part 4 of this build will begin instruction book 2, and we'll continue on with some of these main tower pieces. That's it for now. Thanks for watching. Make sure to check us out on Instagram, subscribe, and we'll see you next time.